Hello, I'm Melissa Armstrong and I'm here to talk about the relationships of sound in film.
Dracarys.
Throughout this video, I'll be talking about three examples. My first example is Community. Community is a TV show about a study group who, no matter what happens, they remain friends and do what they can to help their college, Greendale. Within this episode, they play a game with avatars to try and help their friend Pierce win his inheritance against his half-brother Gilbert. At the end of the episode, the study group forfeit as they feel sorry for Gilbert as he was neglected by his dad. While there is dialogue in this scene, there is also non-diegetic background music.
We're forfeiting.
Warning. Player forfeit in 30.
Gilbert, the music is slow and has a gentle tone, but is high-pitched to set a forgiving, calm and happy mood. However, the music has an electronic sound to it that tells the audience that the episode is set in the gaming world. As well as background music, there's also diegetic electronic voice, which is telling the group that if they do not return to their seats, they will forfeit the game.
Warning.
The voice is slightly drained out and has a low pitch to it, which makes the voice sound cold. This helps explain to the audience that the group are forfeiting. So what does the sound of this TV show do in regards to the relationship of the film? The background music helps explain to the audience what the episode is about and what mood they should feel towards the characters and the situations. My second example is Django Unchained. This film is about slavery, set in the 1800s, and two men who are bounty hunters who are trying to rescue a female slave who is owned by a man called Michel Candy. In this scene, we see cutscenes of the doctor thinking back to his memory to where he is present in a room. In his memory, he is seeing a slave being ripped apart by dogs. While this scene is shown, the music cuts from diegetic music, see that a young woman is performing on a harp, which is also one of Beethoven's pieces, to non-diegetic music of the doctor's memory. The music is soft and slow and very relaxing, which sets a disturbing mood as the doctor thinks about what he saw. When watching and listening to this, the audience feel uncomfortable and relate to how the doctor feels. In the memory clips of this scene, as well as Beethoven's music, we hear the screaming of the slave who is being ripped to shreds. You can also hear the sound of his limbs ripping and the dogs barking. The limbs ripping would have been created in a Foley studio by peeling open fruit. The sound here happens fast and creates a terrifying mood for the audience. Also during the scene, we hear the clanging of plates as one of Monsieur Candy's bodyguards picks up the plate of white cake. He also knocks the gun back onto his shoulder. As he does this, you can hear a quick tapping of metal. Seeing the guy with a gun and hearing bullets inside moving about helps make the guy look dangerous. At the end of the scene, we see the doctor shouting at the girl to stop playing. As she stops playing, the music stops, and all of the other characters stop what they're doing. For a second, there is silence, which sets an unpleasant mood.
Take your hands off the harp!
What the sound does in this film is create a disturbing atmosphere. The relationship of sound and film in this scene together is used to make the audience feel discomfort and slightly horrified of what they are watching. My third example is Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones is a popular fantasy TV series with lots of plots, romance, anger, and with one particular character, Daenerys, who owns three dragons, in which she plans to take over the Iron Throne, which lots of other people are fighting to get. In this scene, we see Daenerys say, "Dracarys." Before she says this, there is non-diegetic background music, which has a hard tone, low pitch, and gradually gets faster. This was created to build a thrilling tension and mood. Once she says the line, the music suddenly stops, and with faded diegetic sound of people screaming in the background. The music stopping represents that something is about to end, and second later, a man is burnt alive by one of the dragons. While the dragon burns its body, there is a loud, high-pitched screech from the dragon, with wings flapping and the sound of a blowtorch. As the dragons are mythical creatures, the three sounds would have been created in Foley Studios and put together with the action to make the dragon real. With the sounds put together, it makes the dragon seem terrifying to the audience. Non-diegetic music kicks back in as the victim is screaming in pain. The shot then cuts to the Unsullied army, who are massacring all of the slave owners. Opera music is used at this point. The pitch changes from high to low and the speed remains steady, while the tone becomes softer. Also within this clip, we hear the stabbing sounds and clanking of spears. These sounds would have been created in the Foley studio using a bit of metal banging against other metals and a knife through a melon to create the stabbing sounds. This makes the mood of the scene seem frightful and disturbing.